Oh, greetings, internet. Welcome back to the Cozy Conspiracy Corner. Roll the intro. I actually got a lot of heat on the previous video. A lot of people were triggered, and so I think it's good that I make a little disclaimer at the beginning of all these videos so that people don't take what I say as fact. Everything that I share in these videos are just food for thought, things that I have found to be true to me in this moment. Don't take this information and crash a train into a cargo ship. Have your own discernment, do your own research. I'm just sharing things that have helped me in my life, and I hope that me sharing this will help you as well, or awaken you to actually what's going on. This information isn't gonna resonate with everyone. I'm not here to people please, and I am trying to help. I think if you've seen other videos on my channel, you understand where I'm coming from. I'm just trying to awaken the parts of myself that are still sleeping. If you haven't already, consider subscribing. I made this cool little thing here. Hit the bell notifications so you can be notified every time I make a new video. And let's get right into it. So today, I think I'm gonna stay away from all the COVID stuff, and we're gonna talk about semen retention. This might be information you've never heard of before. I hope this will help awaken you to your true self, because this knowledge has impacted me greatly. So let's start from the basics. Everything is energy, okay? Including our bodies. We're just like electromagnetic beings. And if you think that this flesh suit and this physical body is all that we are, take a look a little deeper, because with the yoga science and everything that I've learned, everything is energy, from our thoughts to our physical being. We're spiritual beings having a physical experience. Our physical bodies are merely just a vehicle, a house, a temple for our soul. Our souls have chosen to incarnate in these bodies to learn specific lessons, to live out and process specific karma. If you think we're just evolved apes that are just coincidentally here, I have to say you're sadly mistaken. Let me get my notes up really quick. All right. So in order to understand what I'm going to share today with you guys, I gotta give you kind of a brief overview of what the energy body is. If you guys have ever heard or studied chakras, you guys will kind of know what I'm talking about. Here's a little yoga science for you, and then we'll kind of get to why semen retention is beneficial, and then I'll get to like a little conspiracy about it. Here, I'll throw up this image here. The chakras are like the energy centers of the body. There's numerous chakras, but we're just gonna focus on the main seven. They're located in the astral body, positioned running upwards along the spine. And so each chakra coincides with the gland and the physical body, and each of them radiate a specific color and energy. And when your chakras are all balanced, then you have a very healthy mind and physical body. Chakras can become imbalanced, and that causes disruptions in the physical and in the mental. So people that have like digestive issues, heart issues, it's usually energetically related, expressed in the physical. Once you kind of look at the body in this perspective, you can really start to understand where negative ailments and diseases come from and where they originate. It all starts in the energy plane. So starting from the very bottom, this is called the Muladhara chakra, the root chakra. This is located at the base of the spine in between your genitals and your anus, like right where the perineum is. It's like right at the base of your being. It's represented by the color red, and it represents the element of earth. So the essence of it is survival, stability, ambition. It's like your animalistic, instinctual tendencies. It's all at the base. Okay, number two, Svadhisthana chakra. This is a sacral one. It's located in the lower abdomen, about four fingers below the navel. It radiates the color orange, and it represents the element of water. The attributes of the sacral chakra are desires, creativity, and self-worth. Number three, Manipura. This is the solar plexus chakra. It's located above the navel and the solar plexus, between the navel and the bottom of the ribcage. It represents the element of fire and radiates the color yellow. So this chakra is characterized by energy and emotions. And so when it's imbalanced, it can manifest in digestive problems, liver problems, or diabetes. And then we move into the fourth chakra, the Anahata chakra, the heart. As the name implies, it's located right here, and it's represented by the color green, and the element is air. This energy center is characterized by love, compassion, trust, and when it's out of balance, an individual might feel anxiety, jealousy, fear. Number five, the Shuddha chakra. This is the throat, and this is characterized by expression. It's located right here, coinciding with the thyroid gland, and its color is bright blue and the element of space. You can feel when there's like a blockage when you're not expressing your truth. And I felt like just like pressure, and it just felt like, constricted. And as I started making these videos of me just speaking what I feel passionately about, I could feel it like opening and feeling a tension release here. when these energy centers are blocked, it doesn't always show up as like a physical ailment. Sometimes it could be like energetic, or it could be like kind of emotional. Yeah, just kind of look deeper and feel more in tune with your body, and then you can understand when there's blockages or when energy needs to be moved. I'm sure there's science guys that are going to say that there's no empirical evidence of energy, or you can't prove that energy exists, but I honestly feel like you can't see the wind, but you can see what the wind does. You can see how it affects the trees, flags that are waving. You can see what it does to the air and does to the clouds. You can't see wind with your eyes. And it's the same thing with energy. It's like you can feel like when you've had your heart broken, you could feel like your heart actually hurting. Or when you see something incredibly beautiful, you get like the goosebumps all over your body. Energy is like, it's real, but you can't see it with your eyes. You have to feel it within. Moving to the third eye, the Ajna chakra. This one is so fascinating because it's located right between the eyebrows in the center of the brain. If you look at like the anatomy of the brain from the side, there's like a little, if you cut it in half, the cross section, you'll see like a little eyeball there. This is like our connection to infinite source. And this is kind of where we get into the conspiracy, because I think they have been trying to calcify and close our pineal glands for ages. And they do it through putting fluoride in the water, spraying chemtrails, having us watch fear-based media, all these things that kind of close our connection, our portal to the divine. In yoga and meditation practice, usually the focus is brought up to the third eye here to help awaken it. My friend Anna wants me to share tips and techniques on how to open it. I think I'll do that in a later video. Just by taking your eyes and rolling them up and bringing focus to this point, you literally can open it with your mind. You can do it with like diet and not drinking shitty water and doing pranayama breathing exercises to help open it. But generally, you just focus on it with concentration, and that in itself can open up your third eye. The attributes are intelligence, intuition, and understanding. And you can also stimulate it by doing headstands, like doing inversions, like bringing all the energy up here by being upside down. The last of the seven main chakras that I'm talking about is the Sahasrara, the crown chakra, located right at the top of the head. And this is really fascinating because when you see like when a baby is born, right after it's born, the softest part is right at the top of the head. It's like there's like an opening. From the research that I've done, it seems that the soul enters through the top of the head and then it closes as it's being incarnated into this reality. So the top is like the entrance of the soul and the exit when an individual dies. So this is like portal where the soul comes in. It's represented by violet or white, and it's by the thousand petaled lotus. I've actually seen it with my eyes before, not on psychedelics, and it's the most beautiful thing I've ever seen. Once during a really deep meditation practice, and it was like this holographic, multi-petaled spinning thing above my head. It was so psychedelic. It's the center of spirituality. It's like the represented by enlightenment, dynamic thought and energy. It allows for the inward flow of wisdom and brings the gift of cosmic consciousness. So this is like your spiritual antenna. So with an understanding of these seven energy centers in your body, you want to go throughout your life trying to balance them and understanding when they're out of balance, making an active effort to balance them when they are kind of, when you're not feeling right. You can always trace back all of your physical disorders or discomforts back to the energy centers. So if you do a little research, you can find out that like when you're feeling sad or depressed, lack of drive or willpower, if you're feeling a lot of fear and disconnection, it all traces back to your energy body. Try to diagnose your problems next time by looking deeper into what's going on. So let's get into the juicy stuff. Hopefully, my intention is to plant the seed and you guys will understand that it's not just this physical incarnation that we're in. There's multiple dimensions, a lot of things that our eyes can't see. It's like the visible spectrum of light, this 3D dense world is just the tip of the iceberg. There is so much more to life. How do you explain with empirical evidence where consciousness came from? It's like the one question that we always ask is, where do we come from? It's like our memories got erased when we arrived and no one knows where actually the human race or how it all began. They tell us in school that it was like this big bang and then we evolved from single cell organism to monkeys. I just think that's just some indoctrination that they tell us in school. Actually, I feel it in my heart that this is like they're hiding our divinity from us. That's why they tell us this stuff. Because no one actually really knows where we came from. It's like kind of suspicious, right? I'm sure someone knows or it's somewhere and they're hiding it from us. Maybe I'm just way too into conspiracies. I don't know. Let's get into the good stuff. You might have heard of a group called NoFap, a movement online of men that are trying to restrain from masturbation. They have like NoFap challenges and they're trying to have groups of men that are trying to stop themselves from masturbating all the time. So where I'm going with this is that like every time a male ejaculates, they're losing their life essence. And if you really think about it, semen is like made up, is comprised of so many parts of yourself, DNA coding, all of the information that is needed to create another being. When a male just like masturbates and spills his man, I always call it your mana. Like I'm so such a gamer nerd. It's like your magic mana, and you only have like a finite amount. And this is the weirdest part, because science tells us that masturbating regularly is good and ejaculating is good for your prostate, and you can replenish your semen by eating extra proteins. That's like, it's like blasphemy. Of course science would say that. I've learned in the yogic science that like every time that you spill your precious fluid, this might be TMI for you guys, you're actually killing a part of yourself. Like a part of you dies. You look at like in the animal world, when two animals come to mate, sometimes the male will die after he gives his seed to the female. You can feel it in yourself. You think of like all of the athletes, MMA fighters, they always talk about how they never have sex the day before a huge fight or a big game. And that's because they have to like retain all of their power so they can perform at their best. Think of like when you watch porn or after you have sex, the moment that a man ejaculates, he becomes super tired and he's ready to go to sleep. This is actually what I was teaching with Jason. Like we were traveling around Switzerland doing tantra courses and educating men on how to cultivate and sublimate their sexual energy. Because your sexual energy is like your fire. It is like your essence. And if you use it correctly, instead of like spilling it in a toilet or a towel on someone's back, you can like use technique to bring it from your lower animalistic centers, your lower chakras, and then you can bring it up to your third eye and your crown to awaken your consciousness. This is where I'm going with this. I'm sorry it took me so long to get here. We're being taught from young age that ejaculating is okay and you should do it regularly. And we are raised to think that like when a man ejaculates, that's the end of sex, right? It's like after he comes, it's finished. In the yogic science, they say that the energy of one drop of semen, it takes the same amount of energy that creates 100 drops of blood. So if you understand this, how precious this is, you should really make a conscious effort not to let it go. And I've been celibate for a while now and been practicing semen retention for like 3 or 4 years. And I can't even tell you how much it has profoundly impacted my life and ability to just like walk strongly on this planet and be able to create and constantly have so much energy. You think like the highest form of human pleasure doesn't come with a price? Of course, for every reaction, there's equal opposite reaction. So like when a man orgasms and ejaculates, like the highest form of pleasure that we can experience, of course there's the other side of the coin where you feel depleted and then you fall asleep. You are wasting your essence every time. Every time you spill, part of you dies. I hope you guys can understand that. I hope that this encourages you to kind of like retain it. Coming back to opening your third eye and stuff, I think the conspiracy is that the people that are in power want to keep us from awakening and connecting to source. Porn is like one of the biggest industries on the internet. And during all this COVID stuff, Pornhub was giving away free memberships so people could stay at home and not go out and masturbate all day and deplete themselves. And you look at it from like an animalistic perspective, right? It's like ingrained in our minds that we need to spread our seed so that our DNA lives on. This is operating from an animalistic survival perspective. Of course, we want our genes to live on, so we're always trying to seek the best mate so we can give our seed and then create more offspring, and then our DNA lives on. But that's living from the lower chakras, right? From the survival instinct. Luckily, we are humans and we can discern and we can consciously choose to live from higher centers. You can deliberately choose not to participate in these sensory physical pleasures. They will end up keeping you trapped in this incarnation, in this physical dense reality. You will forever be in the cycle of reincarnation, of rebirth and death, if all you're here for is experiencing the pleasures and the dense physical things in this reality. And of course, you know, we're here to learn, we're here to grow, we're here to like cultivate our soul so we can like advance. If you're going through it, then be okay with it, but also know that every thing that happens in your life, there is a lesson behind it. Our purpose is to level up. Like this whole thing is an RPG, so try to level up quickly instead of being stuck in the constant circles. Because you know in your heart that like the short pleasures never really lead to the lasting fulfillment. You can only find it by going within. Okay, so So I gotta send you guys off with some value because I can't talk about conspiracies and stuff without giving you guys something to leave with. That wouldn't be very nice. Do a little research. I think fluoride is one of the most awful things that they have put in our water and our toothpaste. They have brainwashed us to believe that fluoride is good for your teeth. It actually calcifies and hardens your pineal gland. Literally creates like a coating around your third eye so that it disconnects you from the divine infinite consciousness. So one thing that you guys can do today is to check your toothpaste and make sure there's no fluoride in it. And then when you drink water, make sure it's filtered, distilled. And it's just not from the tap, because the tap water, they literally fluorinate the water that is coming through your kitchen sink. Also, a simple prayer can energetically charge your water. So maybe put it out in the sun, bless it before you drink it. That should make a big difference in your life. It has greatly impacted my life. It's hard to describe, but you feel more like connected to your intuition. Really make an effort to take fluoride out of your water, and then maybe you can experience the benefits as well, because they are keeping us asleep. Awaken your energy body. Understand that everything is connected. Understand that there's deeper layers past the physical that we can see with our five senses. This is a really magical incarnation, and we are being put into this really dense perception that stops us from seeing the magic. Second tip I have for you, for men and women, this is really powerful. Throughout spiritual practice, the bandhas is like one of the most important aspects of yoga, in my opinion. There's three locks that you can do. I'm just gonna share one with you guys today, and it's called the mula bandha, and it's called the root lock, okay? This is the same muscle that you contract when you're trying to hold your pee. In the modern world, that's also called Kegels. What you do is you hold this muscle. You can even exercise it throughout the day. If you can hold it for long periods of time without letting it go, that's when you've mastered your sexual energy. We can talk about all the sex stuff in later videos, but for men, when you feel like you're about to like go over the edge, you squeeze this muscle and then you send the energy from your lower chakras up. It's called sublimation, and this is like a whole video in itself. If you guys look at Jason's channel, he talks a lot about this stuff. Take the energy from your lower sexual organs and bring it up to awaken your third eye and open up your crown. Practice this often. You can practice it right now. Just practice squeezing it, pulsing it. You can do it while you're driving and master this muscle. Instead of ejaculating, it's like injaculating. You can go in. This will keep you younger. This will help you live longer. You'll have more energy. You'll be more radiant. And even for women too, you can just like practice moving the energy from the lower chakras up to the higher ones. I feel like this is just scratching the surface. I have so much more to tell you guys. I didn't want to make today's video about all the current events, because there's already enough stuff about that out there. And yeah, I've actually been doing a little research about the Gates Foundation, Bill Gates and Melinda Gates, and it seems that they are behind Agenda 2020, where they are going to force and impose mandatory vaccinations. I don't know too much about it right now. If you guys know, please let me know in the comments below. Send me some links. I'm always open. I'm so excited about all the people that are engaging with the conspiracy videos. I'm glad that I'm not the only one that thinks that there is something going on. I want to leave you guys with this really cool quote that I saw yesterday on this book that I'm reading. It's called The Book of Life by Krishnamurti. He's a sage. He gives such good advice, and the reason that this quote resonated with me, this little excerpt, is because if you look at the way the world is right now, it's merely a reflection, like a mirror of what's going on within ourselves. You look at all the current events, it's just like our shadows manifested in the physical reality. I learned this in a lot of my peyote ceremonies. When we're sitting in ceremony and you feel really triggered or you feel a lot of discomfort when someone else is really upsetting you, really look at it and understand that that's just a mirror of you. Like the parts that you don't like about that person are just parts that you don't like about yourself. And this is like the hardest thing to take responsibility for, because so often we're just blaming everything external for all the problems that we have, when in fact, they're just reflecting back parts of ourselves that we're not happy with. And also that goes to the same thing about the positive things. If you notice something positive about someone else, it's because you have that already within you and they are reflecting that back to you. Everything's a mirror. It's all a freaking reflection. And when things cause discomfort within yourself, it's like an initiative to look within. Dive a little deeper and understand why it's bothering you. Don't just be like, that person sucks. That person annoys me. I don't like that person. It's like, no, you actually don't like that part of yourself that that person is representing. I know this is like, if you've experimented with psychedelics, you probably know what I mean. If you've never had a psychedelic experience, next time someone pisses you off, look into it. Really just see it and understand that person is you. It takes a lot of responsibility to do it. It's not fun. You can actually find resolve and understand that It's just parts of you just trying to bring you back to yourself. Okay, sorry, a lot of stuff I had to share in this video. The little excerpt is, you and I are the problem, not the world. The world is not something separate from you and me. The world, society, is a relationship that we establish to seek or seek to establish between each other. So you and I are the problem and not the world, because the world is projection of ourselves. And to understand the world, we must understand ourselves. The world is not separate from us. We are the world, and our problems are the world's problems. So I hope that encourages you to look within, and you guys can hopefully start to gain more clarity that everything that's happening in the world right now is just a reflection of ourselves. It's our darkness and shadows coming out and manifesting in the physical reality. Hope that doesn't sound too woo-woo, but from my experience, this is the way to liberation. This is the way that you can process all this stuff, bring it to the light, and be at peace with it. So with that being said, may all beings be free and happy and liberated. Thank you guys for watching. Consider subscribing. Let me know in the comments what you thought about this one. I just felt a little timid to go even deeper with all this stuff, because a lot of people shatters their worldview when I talk about stuff that doesn't match their belief system. Most of the feedback has been very positive, but the negative ones have definitely shaken me up a little bit. So I thought this episode could be a little bit different from the other ones. I appreciate all you guys out there, and sending you a lot of love and health and longevity. We'll see you on the next one.